Andy Rubin, head of Google's Android team until 2013, famously defined Android's openness with this tweet, offering the instructions for downloading and building the Android source code. As app developers, it's handy to be able to peek behind the curtains and see how the framework actually works, and it's an excellent way to find answers to tricky Stack Overflow questions. But the Android Open Source Project, or AOSP as it's commonly known, is much more than that. The source code is available under the Apache 2 license, so anyone can take it and do anything they want with it, including modifying it and redistributing it. And they have. Android has always had a passionate community of modders, from Steve Kondik and the Cyanogen community, to XDA and many others who have been distributing modified images of Android for phone owners brave enough to try them. Even big companies like Amazon have taken the Android source code and modified it for use in their own line of products. That openness extends to the apps themselves. The AOSP includes key mobile apps like the dialer, app launcher, calendar, and email, and Google offers its own versions of each as well. In the early days, those native apps were tightly bound to the framework and could only get updated along with the platform, which admittedly in the early days seemed like every few weeks. But as the time between platform releases grew, so did the efforts to unbundle those apps, allowing them to be updated through Google Play. That was great news for users, but it had an even better side effect for us developers. Because apps like Gmail and Maps depend on a number of proprietary Google APIs, Google released Google Play Services, also codenamed after food, to support the Google apps, while also giving us developers Google-specific APIs like Maps, Wallet, Drive, and YouTube. So now we get the latest and greatest Google-specific APIs every 6 weeks or so, and rather than being tied to a specific platform, they're available on every device back to Gingerbread. Oh, and of course, every native app is also entirely replaceable. So you can publish apps to replace any of the apps shipped with a device. And we can build our own SMS apps, home screens, or Maps apps, publish it on Play, and give users the choice to make it their default. When Android was first announced, Andy Rubin described the AOSP as all the software to run a mobile phone, but without the proprietary obstacles that have hindered mobile innovation. Today, Android runs on more than just mobiles, but the core of its purpose remains the same. A platform and ecosystem that allows modders, carriers, OEMs, and app developers to innovate and compete. So, armed with an open, evolving platform, enriched by a growing set of Google APIs, and the ability to create great apps that let users customize every aspect of their user experience, you can use other people's work to help define the computing platform of the future. And that's my definition of open.